Hey guys, it's me, Seren, back with another video. Today is the 23rd day of Hidden Figures. We're in the home stretch of daily videos for Black History Month. And today's Hidden Figure is Susan Maria McKinney Stewart, who was born March 1847 and died March 17, 1918, who was an American physician, women's rights activist, and author. She was the third Black American woman to earn a medical degree and the first in New York State. Her career focused on prenatal care and childhood disease, and from 1870 to 1895, she ran her own practice in Brooklyn. She also co-founded the Brooklyn Women's Homeopathic Hospital. McKinney Stewart was born Susan Maria Smith to Anne and Sylvanus Smith in what is now Crown Heights, Brooklyn. She came from a family of wealthy pig farmers, and her parents were civically active socializers in Brooklyn's Black community. Her sister, Sarah J. Garnett, was the first Black American female school principal in the New York City public school system, and I have her in my back pocket for another Hidden Figure also. McKinney Stewart was a noted organ player, choir master, and musician who was motivated to enter medicine after the death of her brother in the Civil War and the New York cholera epidemic of 1866. She used money earned from teaching music in Washington, D.C. and New York City to fund her medical school education, and in 1867, she attended the New York Medical College for Women and graduated as valedictorian in 1869. Despite her achievement, New York newspapers did not print her valedictory. In 1870, over 20 years after America had seen its first American woman physician, Stewart set up shop in New York. She was the first Black woman doctor in the state. McKinney Stewart's focused on prenatal care and childhood disease, working with patients of all races. She authored many papers on women and children, especially Black women and children's health. From 1870 to 1895, she ran her own practice in Brooklyn and co-founded the Brooklyn Women's Homeopathic Hospital and Dispensary, which was later renamed the Memorial Hospital for Women and Children. During this time, she also completed postgraduate education at the Long Island Medical College Hospital in Brooklyn, graduating in 1888. From 1892 to 1896, she practiced at New York Medical College and Hospital for Women in Manhattan, in addition to her own private practice. While in New York, she sat on the board of and practiced elder medicine at the Brooklyn Home for Aged Colored People. She founded the Women's Local Union, a Black New York leading women's club, as well as co-founding the Equal Suffrage League of Brooklyn. She was also president of the Brooklyn Women's Christian Temperance Union, No. 6. Her patients called her Dr. Susan, and she kept an office in Manhattan. In 1871, she was married to Reverend William G. McKinney from South Carolina. They had two children, and he died in 1894. In 1896, she remarried to United States Army Buffalo soldier and chaplain Theophilus Stewart. After they were married, she would leave New York, traveling west with him to states like Nebraska and Texas to treat the sick and injured, and earning more medical licenses in Montana and Wyoming. From 1906 on, she worked as a college physician and teacher of health and nutrition at the African Methodist Episcopal Church's Wilberforce University in Ohio, or the AME Church's Wilberforce University. In 1911, she attended the first Universal Race Congress at the University of London in the UK, where she delivered a paper on colored women in America. In 1914, she gave another speech entitled Women in Medicine at the National Association of Colored Women's Clubs Convention. She died March 7, 1918 in Wilberforce and was buried at Greenwood Cemetery, Brooklyn, New York. W.E.B. Du Bois gave the eulogy at her funeral because he knew everyone. In 1974, Brooklyn Junior High School was renamed Dr. Susan Smith McKinney Junior High School in her honor. In 1976, Black women physicians in the New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut area, or the tri-state, named their society after her to honor her life and work, the Susan Smith McKinney Stewart Medical Society. She wrote, so this is a quote from her, "Fortunate are the men who marry Black physician women. They are blessed in a threefold measure, taking unto themselves a wife, a trained nurse, and a doctor." And I'm also going to read you guys a little bit of an excerpt on Black women physicians in this era. Black women physicians founded community healthcare institutions, trained nurses, educated people on proper sanitation and hygiene, and founded service agencies to help the poor and oppressed, both Black and white. But unfortunately, their need in society became overshadowed when medicine became more scientific and more white male dominated, thus significantly reducing the number of Black women doctors by the 1920s. And I just find like Reconstruction and post-Civil War, but pre-Jim Crow era to be a very interesting period of time because like basically since Black people were never previously seen as human beings, there were no rules for us. There were no laws for us. You know, like there were no laws and rules for Negroes. And so post-slavery, post-Civil War, you had Black people like becoming doctors, becoming lawyers, opening up these businesses, opening these practices, you know, establishing these communities. And then the whites were like, oh, wait, hold up. We need some rules. Oh, we need some rules for these Blacks. We need some rules. Wait a minute. So that's Susan Maria McKinney Stewart, a hidden figure. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. I will include links and information in the description box. Food for thought as always. See you guys tomorrow with our 24th hidden figure. Can't believe we're just really in the home stretch of February. So see you guys tomorrow. Peace.